Now, after Metro Manila, the Calabarzon region is also restricting the movement of the unvaccinated amid concerns on the more infectious Omicron variant. Calabarzon is comprised of Cavite, Laguna, Batangas, Rizal, and Quezon. To give us a picture of how this will be implemented, we have with us via Zoom Batangas Governor Ermilando Mandanas. Good morning, Governor, and welcome to The Rundown.
Good morning, Stanley, and to all of your viewers.
Okay, first off, let's talk very briefly about the COVID situation in your province, given that Batangas and the entire Calabarzon area would tend to mirror the COVID-19 situation in the NCR with the very porous borders. How many cases do you have now? And please describe to us how exponential the growth is, if it is.
You know, we have every day, we have a report for the past 7 days. And, well, do you want us to be yesterday? The report given to me is that the new cases is the one that's really very revealing that the province of Batangas really has the same concern as everyone else, not only in the Philippines, but the whole world. For this week, ending yesterday, we have 629 new cases. Now you have to compare this to the week before Christmas. The week before Christmas, that we had only 57 new cases, and then before New Year, we had 431 new cases. So from 57 went up to 431. And then, well, after New Year, as of yesterday, we had 629 new cases.
Okay.
So in Batangas, it is confirmed. And personally, we always follow whatever the national IATF would really impose as regards measures that have to be taken. And I would share the view that we should be in the same alert level
as Metro Manila.
Well, right now in Calabarzon, we already have Cavite and Quezon already included. But we are all near. And in Batangas, especially, because we have a super spreader here, and that is the Port of Batangas.
Right.
As everybody knows, it is the gateway of the nautical highway. Using the ships, the vessels, we have three times more passengers,
right,
shipping lines than Port of Manila.
Right.
So, and this would go all the way from Visayas, Mindanao.
All right.
And then back,
okay,
to not only Calabarzon, but Metro Manila and the entire Luzon. So you could imagine why we have really since before anticipating this. We put up a quarantine, a center of a quarantine hub right there in the port. The province has a building there, which was supposed to be for livelihood, which we have converted into a quarantine hub. And we have also asked Philippine National Railroad, that has an idle property contiguous to the port, to convert it using our own funds to a real Batangas Philippine National Railroad quarantine hub because of the present situation. And now, which has been going on for these past years. Of course, in both cases, although we have offered, we have no reaction yet from Philippine National Railroad, whose land is really full of informal settlers. So we're pushing this. And last Monday, considering this in our Batangas Provincial Local Health Board, we have decided that, well, we will implement the universal health care law. I have asked already since last year Secretary Duque to have it implemented as required anyway.
Yeah.
It's the best way because we could use the special fund which we have been using and at the same time really help in funding all the private hospitals and government hospitals, which right now are really complaining with PhilHealth. But with the use of the universal healthcare law, that could be done. And because they're defined resources with the local governments in Batangas, for example, can now be able to integrate our funding, which starting this year, January, has increased because of the Supreme Court ruling. So we will be able to fund. Our concern in funding right now is really following the indication of the president, supported by all the experts, is really to intensify vaccination.
Okay. I'd like to go back to vaccination in a bit, Governor Mandanas. Just backtracking on level 3, are there special regulations, special guidelines in Batangas when you are under level 3? I mean, would you also ban or prohibit the entry of the unvaccinated residents to big areas such as malls and other public spaces?
Well, we haven't been declared yet, right now. But in Batangas right now, our focus, as I said, is really vaccination. Why? That is the one that we are intensifying right now. Because you could see that in terms of being infectious or being contagious, this very little we can do. What we're doing right now, because there are two issues here. Being contaminated, having new cases, and at the same time, the recovery. So, since we have now, we are again putting up posters about the need for hugas, iwas, mask, and vaccination. There are two issues. The contagion, but there is something very you would say mitigating in this particular surge, and that is the recovery is very fast. We had a surge in contamination, but also a surge, also more than 500 also, or more than 600 also have recovered within, 4 days to 7 days. They recovered the same. So it shows that really, if you are vaccinated, then it's easy to recover, which is really the purpose of vaccination. It's not really to avoid contamination. To avoid contamination, it's obvious and it's proven all over the world that it is the social distancing. You have to be hygiene and at the same time wearing masks, even at home.
Okay, so Governor Mandanas, Governor Mandanas, for now it's clear that there are no additional restrictions yet in Batangas province as to the unvaccinated.
We just follow whatever is required by the national government.
All right.
It's still that we don't have, and we don't think it is required.
Okay.
What is required now is really to intensify vaccination, and that is what we're doing.
Okay. Governor Mandanas, the DILG, of course, and the PNP stepping up police monitoring and quarantine OFWs, and Batangas being one of the provinces with a high number of OFs and OFWs from the region. How efficient is monitoring of compliance to health protocols and quarantine policies in Batangas?
We have the same concern as everyone else.
Right.
It requires discipline of the people. And in our part, we have to put up the facilities. Wherein we could test, wherein we could have vaccination and all that. That's why I was mentioning that we are, and also we have introduced, we have expanded our libreng pagamot. Because once you are contaminated, that is another issue. So while we have been doing this, we are spending right now, we have a budget of 2.5 billion. Which we have spent already half of that. We have ordered already ambulances, and 400 have already been here, delivered. Already finished. It is delayed, of course, and that's why we are. But so that's what we are doing right now. The way to fight it is really, first, of course, is to avoid contamination, which is difficult. Mm. The way to do it is then to hasten the recovery. And that is why vaccination is being pushed also. Those are very concrete. And then those who get sick, we even have health at home, wherein we bring the oxygen tanks and medicine and diagnosed by cell phone, using, of course, our facilities. So we're able to do this, I have to stress, because this have to be done, but it cannot be done by all, because everything, but now it could be done, because the funding of health has been increased.
Okay.
With the Supreme Court decision. So,
all right. Governor Mandanas, you mentioned vaccination is key in controlling the spread of COVID-19 in your province. Please tell us about
the vaccination efforts
in the province.
Sorry.
Can you tell us?
I didn't say that with regard to controlling contamination.
All right.
But vaccination is for hastening the recovery. To when it comes to contamination, we have to stick to hugas, iwas, mask.
All right. Please tell us about the vaccination efforts in the province. Are you offering booster shots, and how can residents avail of these services?
Now, we have it walk-in, okay? Because now the national government has been providing us with enough vaccine already. That's why you could see that Calabarzon, as a region, in the records of the national, we have, you would say, one of the best in terms of vaccination. And Batangas has been modeled. We have even mobile clinics. All our hospitals are vaccination centers. And we have a provincial vaccination center right in the capital. So, and all our local governments are really being pushed. And with the help of the private sector, of course, some party list like Anakalusugan has provided us with mobile clinics, personnel, and helping us also in the implementation of our Libreng Pagamot, which means that everybody, because what the concern here is the recovery.
Okay.
That's as you said.
Okay, so, Governor Mandanas, so, perhaps, sorry, sir. As a parting shot, perhaps you'd like to make an appeal to your constituents on the COVID situation in Batangas and how you can help each other in weathering this through.
Well, we are appealing, you know, it's not only Batangas, as we all know. This is COVID, the fight against COVID. I have no boundaries. That's the first thing. So really the appeal is as already being done by the national government, but have to be implemented through the local governments. So as I said, our appeal, we're putting up our posters, social media, national media, and then really having the facilities like vaccination, like our testing, our isolation units, to expand them. And what is important is really discipline. Discipline. I mean, it's very important to follow all these basic medical guidelines. I myself, I had myself had my booster shot last Monday. We had our, and there you could see that our vaccination center for the province in the provincial capital is really packed with people. So we just disseminate all these things. And I'm very thankful that media like yourself would really help. It's a matter of not only information, but discipline and the people. and on the part of the government to really implement the guidelines. And you could see that everybody is trying to do this.
All right. So that's all the time we have.
It's a matter of discipline, cooperation, and one thing very important. Really, everyone has to pray, because it is something that is way beyond the capability of even the top scientists of the world.
All right. Okay. That's all the time we have for now. Thanks a lot for joining us, Governor Mandanas. Ingat po kayo.
Thank you, too.